My parents were awesome in that my dad graduated at Auburn. He was an only child and he went to war. He came to Auburn and got a mechanical engineering degree. He was an achiever in that if there was work to do, he was going to do it. My mother was a taskmaster. She did not go to college. In fact, my mother did not graduate from high school. She didn't need any high school or college. She was born with it. So I think both of them instilled in the four children they had, and I'm the oldest, work ethics. You know, mother would say, can we go play? Get your chores done and then we can play. So we got our chores done and then the rest of the day we were playing. And she stuck by her word, you know. She would come through the house in the morning and say, get up, get up, get up. The day's half over and we'd roll over in the bed and look, it'd be 6:30 in the morning. We gotta go pick those beans. The day's half over. You know, she had been up hours and the day was half over. And I can remember picking those beans early in the morning and an airplane would fly over and I'm thinking, one day I'm gonna know what that's like up there. I've just got to get up there and see what that's like to look back down on the earth from an airplane. I'd never been in an airplane.
Nelda Lee's curiosity in aviation would stick with her most of her life. She soon set her sights on becoming one of the first female students in the mechanical engineering department at Auburn University.
My interest in engineering came from my dad and living on the farm, because we were constantly fixing things on the farm. We could not call some man to come out and fix things, not even the plumbing. We had to know how to fix everything. So I would follow my dad was good at that. He was a very creative man. So I liked that part of my career maybe was, how can I apply fixing things, designing things, building things, which he did. So all of that was my interest. So as I was thinking about a career, the space program was big in the 60s, and I knew nothing about an airplane, but an airplane just fascinated me. So I started looking, and Lockheed over here in Marietta offered me a job as a technical writer, and I thought, no, that wasn't it. And then Boeing in Seattle, for the commercial side, offered me a job. And McDonnell Douglas in St. Louis offered me a job in structural and mechanical design on the fighter program. So I interviewed them and they offered me a job in structural mechanical design. I think Boeing Seattle did and Lockheed did. And the pay difference between the St. Louis job and the Boeing Seattle job was $50. $50 more for Seattle. I said, well, I can't go to Seattle on $50, so I might as well go to St. Louis. Can you believe that's the logic? That was my decision making. The $50 decided that I was going to go to St. Louis and work on fighters. Yeah. So I went and took that job, structural and mechanical design, working on the DC-10 wing at the time, designing the wing, and the rest is history. I just loved it. It was meant for me. I found my niche. It worked out great. I got a little bit of the commercial side with the DC-10, and then I quickly moved over to the military side, designing the wing for the F-15 fighter and then the F-18 fighter, and then I went to flight test. When I came to Auburn, I had studied engineering, but I didn't really know about flying. So I thought, you know, for me to be a really, really good aerospace engineer, it'd help if I knew what all this meant, put it to real application. There again, it goes back to my farm, you know, apply what you're learning here and do something with it.
While at Auburn, Nelda Lee was able to obtain her private pilot's license and instrument rating, which fulfilled her childhood dream. This would also prove very beneficial to her career in the flight test department at McDonnell Douglas.
So the more I learned about the company and flight testing, and I'm flying and I'm going out to the airport and I'm learning more myself, I'm thinking, I need to be over there in that flight test department. where they're flying the airplane. That's where the real rubber hits the road. Therefore, I got more flying done. I learned a bit about the company, and next thing you know is I'm over in the flight test department. That's how that happened. I've only flown the F-15 one time, and I was privileged to do that because of my job. I always wanted to fly it since I worked on it, and I had studied it and had to learn the systems. I thought, I need to go for a flight. It's kind of like, you know, I've got to do this to be better at this. I'd be a better flight test engineer if I could get in the airplane. And lo and behold, one day the phone rang and said, Nelda, are you ready for your flight? I couldn't believe it. I had all of my ratings, so I could fly the airplane and log the hours, which is what I got to do. The airplane performance is unbelievable. The takeoff, you know, you just sit there and when you take off, you're just slammed in your seat because of the power of the engines. I did not black out, I did not get sick, but I had a headache for a week. I have the Auburn Creed. I had it in my office at work. When I retired, I took it down. I took it home, put it in my office at home. I mean, I have a little work area, and it's hanging on the wall because that's what I believe. I mean, I learned everything that's in that creed here at Auburn. Even if you don't have it written down, if you walk around, you'll see it. You know, it's here. It's among us, and I like Auburn. I got something from Auburn. Auburn kicked me off into the world with a good start. I believe in it.